Hey everyone, and thanks for jumping back into the cryptoverse. Today, we're going to talk about Bitcoin and the fact that we are now testing the 50-day simple moving average. If you guys like the content, make sure you subscribe to the channel, give the video a thumbs up, and also check out the sale on the premium list, which you can find a link to in the description below. You can lock in the lower rate on that. Let's go ahead and jump in. So the 50-day is something we've said to, you know, to keep an eye out for a long time. Over the last several days, in fact, since we've been rallying to say, okay, well, after we get past the 20-day, or if we get past the 20-day, if we're able to break our downtrend, then we're going to be looking at our 50-day moving average. Now, when we look at the 50-day simple moving average and see where it currently is, it's actually at around $34,339. So right now we're slightly above it. But this will be an interesting area to see if we can get above immediately or if we have to spend some time battling it. If you go look, the last time we tested the 50-day SMA and held it as and actually held it as support was back in March. Before that, it was in January, and then we sort of came back up to the 50-day SMA over here, but we're unable to stay above it for more than a week or so. Now we're testing it for the first time, in fact, since the middle of May. So it's been quite a while since we've tested the 50-day moving average. If we go over to, say, our 4-hour chart, which we don't really look at 4-hour charts too much on this channel, and we draw our general downtrend lines, you could start to make the case that we've broken the downtrend, right? You could start to make the case that we're broken the downtrend. Remember yesterday, we said, look at the relative strength index on the daily time frame, right? The daily time frame, and you can note that we already broke the downtrend there, right? We broke the downtrend there. So that's not to say we're immediately going to go back to 60K, but what it does say is that it's at least a point for the bulls. And over the last couple of months, the bulls haven't really gotten many points because while most things have been trending down, I mean, the price has been trending down, the daily RSI has been trending down, so up until now, it's basically just been all the points have been going to the bears. Now we have a point for the bulls. Not to say that we put in a local high yet or anything like that, but we broke the daily RSI downtrend and we're trying to decisively break this downtrend. Okay. So we could look at this. We could look at this and say it's already broken. The main issue I see with that is, you know, if it were to come back down, we could just slightly readjust this line and say, all right, yeah, like it's still in a downtrend. So I would say let's give it a little bit longer. One thing to look out for would be, can we actually put in a new higher high? Because the last time we came up to this level, we actually went up to around 34.7K. So really not that far above where we currently are, right? Not that far above where we currently are. Can we put in a higher high? Can we get above 34.7K and then subsequently 35K, 35.9K or 36K, and then 36.6K? I mean, if we can knock out all of these milestones, then it might give the bulls more confidence to actually build out, to actually build this area out as support before we can actually go to the 20-week SMA. Because the 20-week SMA is really where we need to get to before Bitcoin can really resume, say, a bull run, okay? If we go look at our bull market support band, which again is a combination of the 20-week SMA and the 21-week EMA, the 21-week EMA now is at $39,327. So that'll be a big test. Can we get above the 21-week EMA? But beyond that, what do we have? The big one, right? The one that I think matters the most, the 20-week SMA, which now is trading at a fairly, you know, I mean, it's not, I mean, we're over $10,000 away from it. It's at $45,422. So we're still well away from the 20-week SMA. Remember, in order for us to get super bullish again about a six-figure Bitcoin, what we would like to see would be to go above the 20-week SMA, come back down, test it as support, and then go up. That is when I would get super bullish about a six-figure Bitcoin. But we need to see that happen first. Until that happens, we're just continuing to play in the sandbox. Something that might be worth keeping an eye out for is our monthly candles, because our monthly candles, so far, we've had 3 red monthly candles. We're currently in the 4th candle. If the price of Bitcoin can close above $35,060, then this will flip green and it won't look quite as quite as bad to just see so many reds in a row. If this one gets above, you know, about 35.1K or so, we will be flipping that back to green. So we have about a week or so to do that. That'll wrap it up for the video. We'll keep a close eye on things. Can we decisively break the downtrend on the price? It seems like we're very close to doing it. And you could argue that we've already done it. But let's put in a local high first, a higher high, and see if we can more decisively break it. We already broke the daily RSI downtrend, so at least that's one point for the bulls. If you guys like the content, make sure you subscribe to the channel, give the video a thumbs up, and also check out the Telegram channel, which you can find a link to in the description below. Remember, we do have the premium list sale. If you want to know how I'm navigating these markets, and you get weekly reports and videos, the Telegram alerts channel, the Telegram chat room, the risk dashboard, the Into the Cryptoverse app, and more. So go check that out. Thank you for tuning in, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.